Welcome back. In this lesson, we're going to learn about Plotly. Plotly is a graphing library in Python that has over 100 graphs that you can build from. You can build basic charts, you can build financial charts, statistical charts, scientific, maps, 3D, you name it. And everything is open source, meaning it's completely free and very easy to use. That's one of the most powerful things about Plotly, is that with one line of code, you can build most of the Plotly graphs and charts. So in this case, we're building the Plotly Express line chart with this line of code after we incorporate the data. And incorporating the data is a big thing in any visualization library. And so there are many different ways to incorporate data and different formats of data. We're gonna see four different ways with four different Plotly graphs in this lesson today. We're gonna go over the API, which is a data set that comes from the web. It's a web connection to a database. In this case, it's Yahoo Finance. So we're connecting to Yahoo Finance, the Tesla ticker, and then we're gonna grab the last 5 days historical price of the Tesla ticker, which will give us, when we print this out, it's gonna give us this chart right here with open column, high column, low column, and the date index. And then to build our line chart, we just do px, which is Plotly Express, dot line. Today's data is our data that we're using. And the y column will be the y attribute will be the high column. So let's run this file. And we do fig line show, and here we see our line chart. The high column is the y-axis, and the x-axis, we don't have to declare, it is automatically the date because it's the index. And this is how you show your graph on the browser. The next example is GitHub. Many people like to put their data sets, CSV sheets, JSON files, on GitHub. In this case, this link right here is from a CSV sheet that Plotly has right here on this repo, the datasets repo. Now to access it through pandas and convert it to a pandas data frame called DF, we have to access the raw link. And the raw link is right here, raw, and here's our raw link. And you can see it ends with CSV, this is our CSV sheet. We'll go here. We put the link right here, we read the link from GitHub online, so you need an online internet connection. And now we have our pandas data frame, we're going to query it, so we only have the Canada country. You can also print the data Canada like we printed here to see the result. And then we're going to plot our bar chart. So let me hashtag this out, put this back in, fig show, and let's run it. And we'll see that we'll get year on the x-axis and population on the y-axis. And this only represents Canada, showing us how the population has risen over time. You see, x-axis is the x attribute, y-axis and data Canada. And here's how we show the figure. Another example is a data set that comes from a Google Drive, specifically a Google Sheet that sits on the Google Drive. Now this sheet I uploaded is right here on my Google Drive. It's called tips CSV with all these columns, tip, sex, smoker, day, time. And so I need the link to share. Here is anyone with a link can view this. I'm gonna copy the link. And then you go here and you put the link right here. So once you have the URL, this link remains the same. You don't have to change anything in here. And now we have our path. We will turn this CSV sheet. We know this is a CSV sheet because it said so here. We'll turn it, it will read CSV into a pandas data frame. And now that we have the pandas data frame, now we include the data in the sunburst. And sunburst does not have a Y and X attributes. It has path and values. Let's hashtag this out, hashtag line 25. Let's run it. And we'll see day, time, sex is the path. Day, time, and sex. Day is Saturday, Thursday, Sunday, Friday. Time is dinner or lunch. and sex is male or female. And you can go into the data, dig deep into it, and see more and more information from this cool sunburst that we built. All the values represent the total amount of bill. So you see here on the hover, the total amount of bill for dinner for, I think it was Thursday, male. Last but not least, we have our CSV sheet that exists on our computer. It's the same CSV sheet, but I'm not pulling it from Google. I actually have it on my in the folder where I have this whole file. This intro-plotly.py is the same place where I have the tips CSV sheet right here. So now because it's all in the same folder, I can do this, pd read CSV. I'm going to read the tips CSV sheet into a pandas data frame, and then we're going to create our histogram, px histogram df, and I only need to define here the x-axis because I want to see the histogram or the distribution of the total bills for everyone, for all days, all times, all smokers. And here we have it. Most of them sit between the $12 to $18 bill. Now the last thing I really want to highlight, let's hashtag this back in, hashtag this out, line 30. I really want to highlight this link right here. This link right here. This link right here, which I'll add to the video as well, is a very important web page you should always bookmark and have open. It's the high-level interface for Plotly Express, and it's for all of the Plotly Express graphs. So we're going to search for histogram right here, and here we see a list of all the attributes that you can use inside the histogram, and here you see explanation of each and every attribute. Most attributes are pretty self-explanatory, x-axis, y-axis, data frame, color, but I highly recommend reading some of these that might not be as clear or as self-explanatory as one might think. So in this histogram, we're also going to use the color and the template. If we go down here all the way to the bottom, we see template. And I gave you here a list, a link to the list of all the possible templates with Plotly. So let's run this. We see that the color column, the color is going to be the time column. So we're going to use a time that pertain to the tips. And so now here we see the color is dinner or lunch, is the different values under the time column in the tips CSV sheet. Total bill is x-axis, and this is just a count. So now you see the two different colors. And that is it. This is all you really need to know as an introduction to Plotly. Don't forget, always use the high-level interface of Plotly, and I highly recommend that you go into the Plotly main page and look over some of these charts that you might want to build. If you want to build a bar chart, go into the bar chart and see the first example, and then just scroll down and see all the different examples and different things that you can do with the bar chart, because it's extremely powerful. You can do a lot with Plotly.